Hey guys, hey, this is Xavier Kelly, and this video right here, I'm about to walk you through basically the Outbrain dashboard. This is 2018, basically as late as like November 7th, so it may change depending on how you see in the future, but majority of the features will still be there. I know a lot of people have been asking about Outbrain and different things I do because I have done a lot of Taboola tutorials, but I want to go through and kind of walk through the dashboard because I think one thing that Outbrain has done a little better than Taboola is really set up the design of the layout of the pages a lot better. But for the most part of what you actually receive, honestly, I think it's best to test between both platforms. But let's go straight into it. First, you need to do, if you don't have an account, you can go through and register, and you can go through and do all that stuff right there. That it goes to make sure you register for the Amplify one. I'm not going to do that because I already have my account, but it'll walk you through that process. So I suggest right now, if you haven't already, go ahead and pause this video now and then go ahead and register and set up all your information. So I'll give you a couple of seconds on that. So the first page, as we continue right here, this is going to be your dashboard. This is basically where everything that you have is set up at. Start up here with your account name. Different campaigns you have, you can jump into different areas. Has your campaign graph right here, and then too as well, they all have their friendly reminders of different items that have been released. So make sure you guys sign up for Amplify. There's a couple different ways you can do it. You can do different things on the lines. If you know, go like lifetime or something like that, you can see more areas. You can see different traffic sources, click through rates, all that stuff right there, and just all everything that has to deal with that portion. So you can do that part as well. So let's go back real quick. Okay, so this is one thing I really like about Outbrain a lot. It's a very clear and easy way to be able to see how your campaigns are doing. You can see by campaign, you can see by day, you can see each individual day of your campaign, how it's going by the publisher. This is actually the publishers that you're actually using. So if you were to go back through here, and then this campaign I was running stuff a little longer ago, I've been doing a lot more testing on Taboola. But if you can see from these parts, you can see your amount spent, your click-through rates over different basic publishers that you may have been using. And you have different click-through rates on different sites, and allows you to be able to determine your spending and different things along that lines. And then you can go through and you can exclude as many publishers as you want and do all those portions. But let's go back real quick. For a second. Okay, so we have our campaigns section. We have all our listed campaigns below. We have just the amount that was spent on these campaigns, which it must during this time period, average cost per click, impression, clicks, and then your basically your click-through rate. And if you don't know what your click-through rate is, basically take the amount of impressions and then divide it by the number of clicks, right? Clicks coming through. And that'll be your click-through rate on that portion. And then this would be obviously this times this equals your cost amount spent. And then on here, obviously you have status, your type of campaign, campaign name, delivery. It is basically what status is it in, the start date, end date, budget, and stuff like that. And you can go navigate over. And two as well on the front screen, you can go through and really change up any of the any of the metrics that you're looking over, different things on that lines. And you can do month, day, week. You do a lot of different things like that. Day, week, month. So you can kind of see how it's going to go on that part. You can change clicks, conversions, all those things. And now we go to the time portion. So this right here will list through all the time basically that you have is right here. And I go about back through every single day that you have been using the platform. You do time, week, month, all those things right there. It's pretty interesting right here. You can do a lot of interesting things. Publisher. This right here, I would say, is the most underused section that people are not using on Outbrain. And I see this time and time again when I'm talking to clients and then looking through their actual Outbrain account. So right here, depending on some sites, you can go to a site if you want to. You can click on this link, and this is Buzzville. And then you can look on this site and you can determine, do I want my content to show up on this page? And this is something that is really interesting right here. You can go through and you can say, do you want it to be on this page? And if this is something you're not doing, so if you're not doing something around startups or anything along that lines, then you won't want your content to show up here. So you'll go back and then you exclude this. And that's, and then it'll be excluded. You go to the next one. And then we do air find. So this right here will be another site. And basically, this is, if you have a product, do you want to be a part of the solution? And you choose so or not choose so. And if you do, you'll keep it there. If you don't, then you'll take it off. There's tons of stuff like that. Like if you're doing something on Sky Sports, and let's say you're doing something on, what this may be about, Sky Sports, if you're doing or something sports related, this is something you might want your site to be on. So you'll make sure that. But literally going through here and reviewing all of these and then adjusting your spend to be able to get on these and those portions really makes the difference when you're doing this right here. You have a higher click-through rate. You have better actions based on what they do once they are converted over. It works so much better. The biggest thing is going through this same way you will go through your AdWords keywords, your negative keywords, and create negative keywords. This is exactly what you should do on this right here on a regular basis. It's pretty interesting right here. And you can see a lot of different sites that you possibly might want to do. And then you can adjust your cost per click per that site so you can get it right on there. Currently right now, they don't have it where you can just do just those sites, but they do have it where you can go through and kind of cancel out certain sites that you don't want to do use after it runs on it. So it kind of sucks in that part. It's not so much like Google AdWords. We can do complete targeting, but we can do a lot of things on that. So let's go geo. Let's go by country. So sometimes it takes a little second while you do a map view, same thing as before. But on this one right here, it's going to break down by country. If you were trying to target a specific country and or you're having different audiences that are in different parts of the world, then this is a good place to come right here based on the amount you spend, your click-through rate, everything along that line is right there. Works out pretty well. You have it listed out and you can choose which countries you want. And you can do by platform too as well. So this is if you're doing something on a mobile app and you're doing a Outbrain campaign and you want to promote your mobile app, and maybe you're doing it like they're doing it over certain people in this area that the app helps people do their taxes. So you run this out here and you say you can't believe what these people have, how much money these people have saved using this tax app. And then you can do that and you can do it over certain actual devices and browsers and in platforms. So if I was running a smartphone app, I will only run it in smartphones. That's the only place I would run it. If I had a mobile application, there's no reason to run it on desktops. If your app can be on a tablet, you would run it there, but you will only run that application, run that campaign on smartphones. Okay, so that's basically the whole part right here. You can choose include in car, you know, archive files and stuff like that. You can do that and play around, look over there. You can kind of mess with that portion too as well. So if you are working on pushing something that is desktop related, only push on desktop. If you're working on an application that runs better on smartphones and tablets, do that. Just try to just locate your money where it is needs to be the best possible way. Okay, so let's go through the next thing. So you can go through and add content up here. You can go through and basically you can add a RSS feed. So if you have a blog post and you want to push those out automatically, or at least have them load up automatically and you still write your titles and everything like that, you can do that. You put your RSS feed into here and then it'll just pull in automatically and it'll start running those through your campaign. So this could be if you have a blog campaign or anything along those lines. So that works out pretty well. Let's go back really quick. And you can create those there and all your pieces of content will load up down here. Let me get back. Okay, so next thing then from there is going to be add content. Then from there, you have add content, and then you can change the dates up here, and then you have your ad campaign. So this right here is going to be where you can set up your campaign. We're going to go in another video to go way more in depth into this, but just know that the next video is going to come out, so I'm going to, this is just going to be user interface for this part, so you can go through and do that, put your trackings, your third party, pixels, all those things along that lines, do your targeting, which that's a whole nother thing. Third party pixels are amazing. We'll talk to you about something else, and you can see exactly your potential reach and how you specifically plan to actually reach there and your cost per click and all those things. So let's go back over here. Yep, yeah, that one. So we have all that part, we have all our information, our data, our reports, and everything along that lines. You have basically different tokens you can do for, like, if you're doing something with another application that needs to link to it, you can do that. Your settings, really your contact, all that portion right there you can have inside of there. So let's go to the next thing. Okay, so let's go from here. So we are in our campaigns. Let's go to our pixels. This right here, you've probably seen on like Google AdWords. You've seen if you're using it on Google Analytics. You need to go ahead and set up these pixels right here, and so you can set up your conversions so you can track these back to what campaigns you're actually running. So if that conversion could be something on the lines of getting someone to sign up for an email, getting someone to download your application, getting someone to purchase something, you can go through all those portions and then walk you through exactly what you need to do. It's pretty simple. All right, you go through and just take this right here and put it on your site, and they walk you through pretty fast and quick. And it's not, it really don't take that much time, and you can be able to see on that portion. But you can go through here, you can add your conversions in, you can view your Outbrain pixels, all those things right there, and you can just copy this in onto your site. I will put this on all my pages. I'll put that somewhere on the lines. If I remember exactly where they have it at this part. Because right now I have it currently in my footer, and my footer gets put onto everything. But you can put it right here, put it on your header. Actually, you probably need to move mine over correctly, but you move it over to there. Okay, so let's go from that right there. So you have that right there. You add conversions. You go through and you go through that portion to add these conversions, or basically what is considered a conversion. That can be anything on the lines from, you know, as you see right here, a URL-based conversion, event-based conversion, which can be something that's taking a lot of download. You can have all that set up and everything on that lines in the window that person, how many days it takes for that person to convert if they come back, and then if that conversion is set up to be with a value. And then you can do all site conversion, including total conversion. You do all types of things right there in that line. We'll go to something different. The next thing, this is another underused item that people are not using on top of Outbrain. One thing is doing audience segments. They don't use this on, a lot of people don't use this on Outbrain. A lot of people don't use this on Taboola. This right here is the gold mine. I really think that the biggest thing you can do is do marketing and then do remarketing. This right here allows you to remarket to different people. And I will have these on my sites, even if you're using Google AdWords or you're doing YouTube, so you can be able to hit them back up and message them as you scroll through other content. And you can be able to hire your audiences on there. And even if you want to carry that over to Facebook or whatever areas you want to do to follow them around, this would be the best way to do. You can basically go through and tell them which way to do it, how to actually, you know, how to go through and segment that list. You can do it by URLs based on what URL they went to, how long do they stand in the list, list names, and then you can do it by story sequence, which is another right here. These are based off of the actual what stories you have put out, and then you can do converted segment, everyone converted, basically anyone converted. So when you have when you set up your pixels and stuff, it goes through there. Next thing, on a regular basis, you need to be scheduling reports. This is something that I didn't do at first, but in my active campaign, what I run with my client stuff inside, I have my schedule. When I don't do this, I didn't do this at first, and it really messed with you. If you want to really to improve yourself as much time, you need to be scheduling reports, monitoring as much as possible how much conversions you're getting from, no matter what those conversion actions are, and to be tweaking it as much as possible so you can be able to attain and get closer to your goals. But it's pretty simple. That's one thing I like about just Outbrain. They have a very simple platform. Everything's really easy to see and to actually use, and it's not much confusion on here at all. As you can see, everything's on the side. You have really three areas: campaigns, pixels, schedule reports, and your payments. I'm trying to show you that because you guys would get in there and see that. But I really like Outbrain, and you're gonna see a lot more videos coming out on this topic too as well. So guys, if you haven't already, I want you guys to go ahead, you know, go to YouTube. Click on YouTube and go ahead and head over to this part of the channel right here on my channel. Go ahead and subscribe over there. I'm gonna do a lot more videos to help you guys, walk you through different things going on, such as if you're in the first part of your product building phase, which could be just you deciding on what audience you want to reach, and then next step will be going through and building that audience. And then if you're looking to build a digital product, or if you're looking to go through and do some more, and sell that product, I'm putting out a lot more videos that are going to go over these specific areas that are going to help you guys build better businesses online and actually start making a return. And you never know, you might sit in there and go through, you listen to what I say, and you keep trying and keep testing, you can make a couple extra $100, a couple $1,000, or if you really put your mind to it, make a couple, you know, make six figures, make more. The opportunities are there to really make and have the lifestyle you want by doing something that interests you the most. So guys, if you want to learn more about that, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. And I thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.